Hello everyone, I'm Haldrie, and what I'm about to show you today is known as the Independence Exploit, which allows you to boot homebrew off of an original FAT PlayStation 2 system. Now, what you'll be needing for this exploit is, obviously, a PlayStation 2 memory card, a PlayStation 1 game, this happens to be Destruction Derby 2, but you can use any PlayStation game that boots on your system, and some way of transferring a modified save file from a USB flash drive to your memory card. Now, what I'm going to be using for this tutorial is the Action Replay Max. I purchased this specifically for this Independence exploit. This is the first exploit mod that I ever used on my PlayStation 2, so I'm finally going to share my knowledge about it with you. Now, anyone that's ever browsed their memory card may have noticed a save file titled Your System Configuration. Within that file is another file type that is named title.db. Now, what this exploit does is modify an entry in there to tell it that whichever PlayStation game that you set to modify in there, whenever you insert that game with this memory card in either slot 1 or slot 2 that has this modified file on it, the PlayStation 2 will check that title.db file for what region that game is actually in. Now, normally it would return the correct region, and if your system matches that region, it'll boot. However, the Independence exploit modifies it to where it gives it a false region, which causes a buffer overrun in the system and allows it to load up whatever code that it wants to. And specifically, it tells it to load up the file titled boot.elf, which will be added to the save file, which can be any homebrew that you could possibly want, just about. The one specifically we're going to be using is ulaunchelf, because with that homebrew, you can then turn around and load up anything you want, modify whatever you want, and you won't have to keep modifying the save file in order to boot different homebrew. Just boot ulaunchelf, boot whatever you want from there. Now, the first thing we're going to do is I'm going to show you how to get the Your System Configuration file off of your PlayStation 2 memory card, and if it's not on your memory card, say you performed a format or managed to delete it somehow, how you can get it back on your system, which is actually fairly easy. I'm going to go ahead and switch over to my PlayStation 2, and then after that, switch over to my computer and show you how you can compile this and get it ready to load up onto your PlayStation 2 system.
Okay, now, if you haven't found it by now, let's go ahead and show you exactly what this Your System Configuration file actually looks like. I'm going to go ahead into the browser, access one of my memory cards that already has a bunch of saves on it, and go over here to the Your System Configuration file. This file is the key file that this exploit is going to modify in order to run homebrew on your unmodified original FAT PlayStation 2. Now, what we're going to do is copy this file off of this memory card and load it up onto our computer using the Action Replay Max. Now, this can, of course, be done with a code breaker or possibly a Game Shark. Now, to be honest, I have not actually used a Game Shark, so I'm not really sure if it has the ability to transfer saves to and from a USB flash drive. I know that the older Action Replays have it, such as the one that I have, but the newer ones, if I'm not mistaken, have removed that functionality from them because of all of these exploits. So if you're hoping on getting an Action Replay, you pretty much might be out of luck on that. So a code breaker might be your best option, or another exploit. Now, of course, before I begin and show you how to copy the save off of it, what I'm going to do now is pretty much show you how to get the save on there to begin with, in case you don't actually have it. going to insert one of my brand new memory cards that I haven't formatted yet. This is brand new out of the package. So, as you can see, I've got it loaded up. Hit X. Now it's asking me to format. Now, of course, a freshly formatted memory card isn't going to have anything on it. So, go ahead and format. Format complete. No data. So, how do I get it? Well, easiest way to do that is to grab any PlayStation 2 game and boot it up. I'm going to go ahead and place this in the drive. Reading disk. PlayStation 2 disk. Load it up. Give it a little bit. Boot the menu. This is actually a demo disk that I went ahead and just pulled off my shelf. Alright, it's got the PlayStation 2 logo, and so I'm going to go ahead and eject the disk and reboot the system. Now, I'm not sure about slot 2, but slot 1 is definitely the best way to get this done. Now when I go to the memory card, there it is, the Your System Configuration file. Fresh on the memory card. So, now that this is done, it's time to see how to copy it off of the actual memory card and get it onto your computer so that we can actually modify it and get this exploit put on here. Now, the Action Replay Max comes with its own USB flash drive, so before I boot the disk, I'm going to go ahead and plug it in, because with the USB flash drive in there, it won't worry about loading up onto my, or saving all of its settings onto my memory card. It'll default to the USB flash drive. There we go, PlayStation 2 disk loaded up. Now this is going to take a while to load up, so now the Action Replay Max has the feature which I believe it's called, here it is, loaded up. I have the network adapter attached, so it's setting that it's detecting internet connection, but I'm not going to go ahead and do the updates right now. So, want to go over here to max memory. If you're using a code break or anything else, you'll have to refer to the manual on that or try it out and see how you're going to be able to copy the saves off of your memory card or from a USB flash drive. So I'm going to go here to max memory, and it's going to go ahead and load up another piece of software that's on the disk to access the memory card. Okay, now we're into the max memory software. So the first thing I'm going to want to do is go to my devices, and my primary device is going to be the memory card. Here you can see the Your System Configuration file. I'm going to go ahead and check it, and I'm going to say copy to the USB flash drive. Show my copy, yes. And it's as easy as that. Now the save file is on the USB flash drive, and all they have to do is unplug it and plug it into the computer. So now that that's done, it's time to go over to the PC side and show you the various software that you're going to need to use to get and use to make this whole thing possible.